Hi guys, in today's video, I'm going to be discussing opportunity cost, what it is, why it exists, and going over a few basic examples as well as showing you how to calculate opportunity cost. If you like this type of content and more science and educational videos, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. So, what is opportunity cost? The most common way it is described is that opportunity cost is the value to the decision maker of the best alternative that is given up. It is important to note here, it is not the value of all the alternatives given up, but only the value of the best alternative. So, why does opportunity cost even exist? Well, scarcity. Resources are limited while our needs and wants are unlimited. We are therefore faced with the economic problem of scarcity, which forces us as individuals and as a society to continuously make choices about how our scarce resources are used to satisfy our needs and wants. The concept of opportunity cost may be applied to many different situations and arises when we need to make a choice between different alternatives. While opportunity cost is usually expressed in the terms of money, it can also be done in the terms of hours spent or some kind of output measure. Okay, let's look at a few examples of opportunity cost. It is Saturday, and Mary decides to attend a soccer league match which costs her $25 and takes up 2 hours of her time. If she had not attended the soccer match, she would have read a couple of magazines. So let's break down this example. Mary already decides that she is going to attend a soccer league match, and that is going to cost her $25. And it's going to take up 2 hours of her time. If she had not attended the soccer match, she would have read a couple of magazines, and her reading a couple of magazines will be her best alternative because they didn't give us any other options that she would have picked, so that automatically becomes her best alternative. So the opportunity cost will be the $25 she pays for the match and loses the value of reading her magazines. The $25 plus the satisfaction of reading her magazines is her opportunity cost. Note here how it's not just money that she's losing. Her opportunity cost is the satisfaction of reading magazines. Now, let's look at another example. Glenda works as a consultant and earns $50 per hour. It is Saturday and she decides to attend a soccer league match instead of working. The cost of the soccer match is $25 and it takes up 2 hours of her time. So, she's already decided that she's going to attend the soccer league match instead of working. And the cost of the soccer league match is $25 and it takes up 2 hours of her time. Her best alternative here would be going to work. She earns $50 per hour. So here, note that her soccer match takes up 2 hours of her time. And $50 is what she earns per hour. So here in these examples, don't forget to add the $50 plus another $50 because it takes up 2 hours of her time. So opportunity cost is equal to the $25 for the soccer match and the $100 she loses by not working. So her opportunity cost is $125. So let's look at how to calculate opportunity cost. There are many formulas available, but this is the most basic and easiest one, I feel. So, opportunity cost is equal to the return of the next best alternative not chosen and the return minus the return of the option chosen. And here are some simple tips to calculate opportunity cost. Number one, assess the situation. Determine a handful of variables, both positive and negative, that may influence the final decision. In doing so, you can divide the problem into its most necessary components, losses and gains. Determine potential gains. While the initial gain could be obvious, it's important to consider all possible benefits. Think about short-term and long-term financial gains, or if you could save more money by making one decision over another. It is also essential to consider any non-financial benefits. Number three, determine potential losses. Determining losses can be more difficult. It may seem simple to determine how much money you gain initially, but long-term returns are harder to find. There are also several other possibilities that you could miss if you make a decision. Number four, use the formula. Once you have clearly defined your gains and losses, you can determine the opportunity cost. To use the formula mathematically, it's helpful to include gains and losses that can be quantified, like finances. So now let's look at a few examples on how to calculate opportunity cost. You get offered a job that pays $35,000 annually, but you will have to leave your current job that pays $32,000 annually. So how will we calculate the opportunity cost for this? We'll use the formula. Opportunity cost is equal to the best alternative option not chosen minus return on the chosen option. So our opportunity cost will be the $35,000 minus the $32,000, which will give us $3,000. This means you would lose $3,000 if you stay at your current job. Okay, this example is very, very common in exams and tests, and it's also important to know before you learn PPC graphs, which is your production possibility curve graphs. So in this table, we are given the information that if combination A, you can produce 3,000 laptops, you will be able to produce 18,000 mobile phones with your resources. Remember, there can be no other alternatives to these once they give it to you, which you will go more in depth in your PPC graph section. Okay, in option B, you can only produce 4,000 laptops and 10,000 mobiles. So the information in the above table shows that the opportunity cost of increasing the production of laptops from 3,000 to 4,000, that is by 1,000, is the loss of production of mobile phones from 18,000 to 10,000. The opportunity cost of increasing the production of laptops by 1,000 is therefore 8,000 mobile phones. So this is how we will calculate it. The opportunity cost is equal to return on the best alternative option not chosen minus the return chosen option. So we will say that the opportunity cost of increasing laptop production is equal to 18,000 minus 10,000, which will give us 8,000. So the opportunity cost of increasing the production of laptops, sorry, This will be laptops, and it will be 8,000. 8,000 mobiles. So that is it for this video. If you have any questions on opportunity cost, then please leave a comment down below and I will try my best to answer it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you like this kind of content and more science and educational videos. Thank you. Bye.